There's a tree that's so endangered that it's endemic to only one specific place in the entire world. That tree is the Wollemi Pine, and it's found in a top-secret sandstone canyon somewhere in Australia's enormous Wollemi National Park. Its nickname is the Dinosaur Tree, and they've been around for millions of years. And while there's only 100 of these living fossils out in nature, researchers are working to change that. With any luck, you might even be seeing them in your local garden store. Wollemi pines are these funky-looking trees with wide needles that give them a fern-like appearance. Red, bumpy bark, and multiple trunks sprouting from one location. So they're more like a lumpy bush than your typical tree, whatever that means. They can live for hundreds to thousands of years, we think. See, it's hard to tell exactly how old they are. Counting their growth rings is tricky when they have multiple trunks, so you'd need to figure out which is the oldest, and good luck with that. And part of why we don't know a ton about them is that until recently, we didn't know the world still had any. Researchers thought that the Wollemi pine went extinct around 2 million years ago. That is, until 1994, when an Australian park ranger accidentally stumbled upon a whole canyon filled with them. At the time, this discovery was coined as one of the greatest botanical discoveries in 100 years. It's the coelacanth of trees, if you will. Wollemi pines belong to a family of trees that were most abundant during the Cretaceous period, when dinosaurs roamed the Earth. Studying this tree family's history has given scientists a peek into past climates and their impact on the vegetation during that time. This, combined with newer research on the Wollemi pine's genome, has helped to piece together the rise and fall of this tree over the millions of years they've been around. Ancient Wollemi pine populations had their heyday between 8 and 6 million years ago, thanks to a unique shift in the global climate. Some 30 million years prior to that, the supercontinent had broken apart. This breakup is what pushed the continents of the southern hemisphere into roughly the places they are today. As part of this breakup, the Sahul Shelf, part of Australia's continental shelf, detached and moved northward. This process alone took millions of years and established the currents that flow around Antarctica. These new currents brought cooler, drier climates, leading to temperate rainforests where Wollemi pines thrived far beyond Australia. But as time marched on, the climate continued to dry out even more, which became too much for the Wollemi pines. It was so dry during the Pliocene epoch that they were restricted to just a narrow region in Australia that had enough rainfall to support their water needs. And they've stayed there ever since.
This SciShow video is supported by Imprint. Since you're still watching this video, you probably like learning, and for a new way to learn, you can check out Imprint. Imprint has courses on topics ranging from health to philosophy to the science of happiness that are built into bite-sized, visual, and interactive lessons you can build a daily habit around. With lessons that can take as little as 2 minutes to complete at a time, Imprint can be a small but impactful part of your day. There's a reason Imprint won Google's App of the Year award this year and has tens of thousands of five-star reviews. You can invest in your mind and get Imprint using the link in the description or by scanning the QR code. As a SciShow viewer, you get 20% off an annual membership on top of a 7-day free trial.
The modern-day Wollemi pine doesn't just look like the trees hanging around during the Cretaceous. Even the tree's genome is similar to its ancestors, earning it the living fossil nickname. These trees don't end up exchanging much genetic material because they reproduce by sending out new shoots from the original plant that are genetically identical to the original stem. It's hard to be genetically diverse when your reproductive strategy is essentially copy and paste yourself. Wollemi pines do also produce seeds, but they take a really long time to develop. However, millions of years ago, when these trees were having a moment, researchers believed that making seeds was their primary reproductive strategy, not cloning like it is today. Sexual reproduction would have added a lot more variety to their genome. Unfortunately, it can also lead to errors like transposons, which are jumping genes that randomly insert themselves into the genetic code and cause errors. Researchers have found evidence of ancient transposons in the Wollemi pine's genome that would have introduced genetic instability into the population. So, facing both the pressure of climate change and an increase in genetic mutations, Wollemi pines probably shifted to cloning to limit the spread of harmful mutations that would whittle down their populations even more. Cloning is also a much faster process, and this strategy may be what kept them from going extinct altogether. Today, there are less than 100 adult Wollemi pines left in the wild, and their location, while known to be somewhere in Wollemi National Park, is a heavily guarded secret. This tiny remaining population faces a looming threat of extinction from both wildfires and a destructive fungus. Recent genetic analysis reveals that the Wollemi pines are highly vulnerable to dieback caused by a water mold that spreads across their wide needles. This mold can be tracked in by hikers, which is all the more reason to keep the location hidden. And in 2020, these trees faced a totally different threat when a wildfire came dangerously close to the canyon where they're sequestered. Thankfully, firefighters stopped the blaze before it wiped out the trees. But it's threats like these that have inspired researchers to try to protect the tree by cloning it so they can continue to study the Wollemi pine in the lab. Horticulturalists are even cultivating tissue samples so that gardeners everywhere can grow one of these trees. So while a wild Wollemi pine is almost impossible to find, you may be able to purchase them at your local garden center and grow it at home. I feel like having a dinosaur tree in your backyard would be extremely cool, even if it's just for the name alone. So that's the story of the rise and fall of the world's rarest tree, from widespread to utterly isolated. And maybe with the help of some crafty horticulturalists, back to worldwide once again.